Okay, I talk about choke points a lot in my videos. You notice it's hot, the shade's here, so you got four horses hanging out by the gate. And I'm going to try and take these two horses out of the gate, so we're going to have issues here. Now this mare's going to walk by, and she should hopefully give me space, and she does. She gives me a little tail swish there, saying don't come too close. Got Roper coming up on these two mares, and you got this gelding here that's a high gelding. So I got to go through all this to get to a gate, because I've created a draw with a shelter to where horses gather, they poop, they get fed here, there's hay here, there's grain here, there's all these draws here, and then people wonder, my horse got kicked and got a broken leg. He didn't get a broken, he got a broken leg because you designed your pasture so poorly that you've created these points to where horses get trapped. Now watch these two horses. This horse goes in here, she's a mare, and the high gelding's in there. But Roper just kind of connected with this little filly because I just took Sassy here. Hi, Sass. I'm going to move them to the other pasture because this one's a little rich and it's got a lot of things. So I'm moving them across the way. So this mare's going to go back in here. This mare's calling because she's upset. So I've got to try to get to this gate without setting up. What some people do is they'll come in here and try to scare these horses out of here. And then they end up pushing them in a corner and they rear or they kick or they run over each other or bang their head on the roof because the roof's too low. So there's all kind of issues that you need to be realizing when you develop your pastures and these choke points and where you put your water and where you put your gates and where you put your shelters and where you put your draws to horses that are going to get them to where they hang out. And the more horses you get hanging out in an area, that's when you get pushiness, you get dominance, you get high horse saying this is my area, you get flexing, these horses come in and want to push and make the lower one move. Not to mention you see all the wasps flying around up there. I knocked down some yesterday. Come on, Roper. Can you come, bud? Come on, Roper. Come on, buddy. Follow us out. It's okay, Sass. Come on. Roper, come on. See, he's kind of getting blocked here. Now this horse is going to want to come in here. Coco, get, don't you come in here on me. Roper, come on. So he's confused. He doesn't want to come by these horses. He doesn't want to come out. So I'll come back and get him. This is me trying to get him is what I call, bye Sass, don't leave me, is what I call trying to do too much at once. You see people trying to control two or three horses because it's easier, it's quicker. Oh, she just kicked him. He got too close. She kicked him. Notice she didn't offer him a cookie. She didn't say, here, Roper, you want a cookie not to get too close to me? She kicked him. She created fear. She created pain. That horse is abusive. Somebody call PETA. We got an abusive mare that kicked a poor gelding because he got too close when she should have offered him a cookie. Come on, Roper, if you come, bud. See, I'm trying to get him in here. And I'm really just kind of showing you what people do to kind of do the. If he comes, great. If he doesn't, I'll come back and get him. It's better to make two trips. The slow way is a fast way. When people try to make one trip, they try to do too much, too quick. You got all these horses in here kind of fighting for their shade. So who gets left out in the shade? The old horse, the low horse, maybe the young horse. And the older, tough boys kind of get the shade, or the older, tough mare gets the shade. So when you don't have enough shade for all your horses, you don't have open shade so horses can come and go, and there's plenty of ways. See, there's only one way in and one way out here. So when these horses, when you develop pastures like this with one way in and one way out, you force to where, luckily right now, these two horses in here are higher than these two out here. So these two get a choice not to go in and get kicked. But if these two, who are lower, were in here, and these two high ones came up, how do they get out without getting kicked? Because a horse expects a horse to yield, and when they don't, and when I tell you to yield and you come at me, I have to correct you. So I kick you or bite you or strike you. This horse thinks it's going to sneak out. Watch it. Nice try. What are you doing? Like I'm not paying attention. Have you lost your mind? It's like, dude, I thought you were talking. I could sneak out. Mrs. Oyer, are you being a good girl? Okay, so Roper's taking a poop. Again, he's not coming in. The mares can come in because the gelding's not going to push them out. The higher mare will push a lower mare out, which is this one, so they're not going to go in there. But all these things happen right here, and this is where horses get hurt. This is where they get trapped. This is where they get cuts on their head. This is when they get trapped in a corner. Somebody goes, that mean horse put my horse in a corner and was kicking it and wouldn't let it out. Horses don't think that way, you freakazoid idiots. Horses don't corner a horse in a corner so they can kick the crap out of it. Hang on, Sass. I don't want you to go back in there. I'm going to take you out in a minute. I know I was talking here. Let me go in here. Horses just do things. It's okay, baby. I know. Those flies are bad, huh? Come on. Let's go over here. We'll come back and get Mr. Roper. So anyway. Ow. Hey. See, she's paying attention to those flies and not me. Come on. I know. Come on. You can rub on me. Don't be hitting me with your head. Come on, baby. It's okay. So, again, when you're developing pastures and gates and shelters and all that, it's so important. And nobody discusses this and nobody wants to think about it. They just go out there and look at other barns. So you follow the blind, trying to let them lead you out of a fire. And you're no better off. So don't question things. Ask, why is this done differently? Good girl, Sass. All right. Ouch. Damn, tail. Mares, their freaking tails are just... So she's going to be a little panicky here in a minute. I'm going to go get her a little... Go get Roper for her. You notice I got a new horse in her. Look at all these horses. Hey, what's going on over here? They're going to come over here to see who's here. Why is there a new mare? Is she higher? Is she lower? Do we know her? Now, they may recognize her. I'm pretty sure they do. But she's going to hang here. I'm going to go get Roper. This little mare that's coming in is the one I scared off the other day and where Tanner stole Sassy. So she's going to come in and probably push this mare. Because she's been trying to move up. Let's see if Sass. And see, Sass went straight by her, which could have been problems. She trotted out, though. Gave her tail swish. Gave a little protest. Said, let me get out to the open. I don't like being trapped. I don't want to be in a corner. So she went out to open area. That's where horses like. Okay, we just had a horse hit his head over here. When I was just talking about it. I don't know what happened. But you see all this dust? See these horses? See that little mare kind of protesting? Again, this happens all day and nobody sees it. Because people come out here, put their horses out, put their halters right here at the gate. So the other horses can, as you can tell, already used it as dental floss. And so all day they're in here fighting. And it's still cool out here. It hasn't got hot yet. So they're out here fighting on who gets the shelter. Who's high and who's lower. This is actually the mom of this horse right here. So she should be higher, but I think she's moved up. And this is kind of the high gelding out here. And then there's Coco, who's the low mare, who won't walk by me. I'm not going to do anything to this horse. You notice she's watching me as I walk by? Watch when I walk toward her. She will move, and I won't have to do anything. I'll walk right by her. Oh, Coco. See, my body language wasn't clear. Normally, I would tell her to move, and she would back right away. She did earlier when I moved in here. So because I'm holding this camera, and I've changed my behavior, and I wasn't being clear, Mr. T coming out. What the hell's going on over there? Do I need to come over and straighten somebody up? And then Hollywood's going to come out and stick his nose in it. Now, see, I do not want to walk by this mare's rear end, because I know she'll kick me. I don't think she'll kick me just to kick me out of disrespect, but if another horse pushes her, she'll tell that horse to get out of her space, just like she kicked him earlier. And if I walk in between here, this is what I call a danger zone. People need to realize this. People get out here focused. Well, this is Roper, and I'm just going to go to him, and I'm not going to mess with her, so I should be fine. BS. If I walk into this horse right now, and I'm in her striking distance of those feet, and he does something to her to make her kick him, guess what? I'm in a kick zone. Stay out of the kick zone. And if you're in a kick zone, make sure you got a rope long enough to get her out of the kick zone. Now I'm going to come over here to where she can't get me. Hi, rope. Just throw a rope over. I know, Roper. You're a good old boy. So now I got Roper, and we'll just go. Come on, bud. We'll go get you to Sass. Come on, I know. I got to watch your feet, because if he gets too close, you may just kick him. This horse kind of came out like his ears. Okay? If we'd have went close to her, I could have gotten in the middle of a fight there, not paying attention, because I'm out here trying to be freaking Steven Spielberg and get my butt head and my head kicked off. Come on, Roper. Good boy. Don't get away from the gate, bud. Hey, see this pressure? See this pressure? Sassy just called him. He's our. He's like, dude, that's my mare. So now he's gonna move. All right, boys. So he dropped his rope now. See? Don't let that horse loose. He may run away. Yeah, he's run away. He's gonna leave his mare. He's going to say, screw you, I'm free, goodbye. That's the way horses think. They don't have any hard draw or anything. They're just stupid animals that if you let them out, they'll just run blindly. And I'm being silly for those who watch my videos. For the new people, they'll be like, see, I knew I was right. Come on, Rover. Hey, come on. I'll let you in, bud. Roper dog, come on. Roper. Sass, no. Now see this? This is a I'm trying to get him in without a rope. And again, I can go put a rope on him. That's what I would do if I didn't want to do this. But for demonstration purposes, I'm going to try to do it easy without a rope and see if I can control them with body language, get Roper to follow me, get her not to come out when I leave this gate open. But as soon as she saw the gate open, she came. So I'm going to try to leave the gate open a little bit. Hopefully she won't come out. Now I'm going to put pressure on Roper for him to follow me. Roper, come. Come. So I pushed him and backed away. He's worried about the flies. Come on. Backing away. Create that draw. Come on, buddy. Roper, come. Come on. And she's right here at the gate. Hopefully she won't push him back out, which she's trying. So he's trapped. He went underneath her. She's swishing her tail. You guys did a good demonstration on how to almost get me smashed. All right. So anyway, that's moving horses and shelters. This shelter here, pretty good. Why? Even though it's at a gate, there's trees and there's another shelter. This shelter's good because a horse can come in here, another horse can leave there. So there's multiple ways in and out so a horse doesn't get trapped. Now, a horse can still get trapped here at this gate, but he still has two access points. He has here and he has here. When you get one access point, like this shelter over here, maybe I'll call this shelters. I don't know how I started this thing. You get one shelter here. Look at all these horses gathering shelter. Look at the kicking. See, that's Mike coming out because he heard me coming over here. He's like, I don't want no problems. That's right, boy. Honking. Look at that head. Honking. Throwing that head. See, he left, but he didn't leave like I submit. He goes, I'll leave, but I don't like it. And I don't know if you're as bad as you think you are. These three are walking out more slightly. But anyway, this shelter here, another poor design. But Rick, it's easy. It's what I put in here. It was on next to the barn, and I only had to put a roof and two sides. And now they have three ways to block the wind. Yeah, but they only have one way in and one way out. And when a low horse is in there trying to get out of the flies and heat, relaxing, and he's got his head in a corner, and he doesn't see, and a high horse walks around a corner and says, what are you doing in my shade? You're supposed to move. Why aren't you leaving? And the horse inside is like, holy shit, I'm trying to leave, and I can't leave him. I'm trapped. And a high horse is saying, how dare you not leave and not respect me? I need to teach you a lesson, because obviously you don't know how to yield to me, and you think you're higher than me, so let me show you you're not. So the horse turns and starts kicking a horse, and you got a bunch of people running out here. That horse had my horse pinned in a corner and was just kicking it, and he's mean, and you can't have him in pasture. Lock him up. Crazy people. All right, we'll end that there. Roper, Sass, you guys are good boys and girls. Hi, little herd. All the horses checking out the new herd members, looking for a leader. These two are kind of chilling out. We'll end that there. Hope that helps.